Hey, Dugout News YouTube channel is what you're watching. Welcome aboard once again, and I got some new news for you in the world of boxing about Timothy Bradley, another legendary fight and Hall of Famer, Timothy Ray Bradley and Shakur Stevenson. Well, Timothy Bradley has criticized Shakur Stevenson's decision to reject Top Rank's $15 million offer. Boxing analyst and former boxer and Hall of Famer Timothy Bradley believes Shakur Stevenson made a big mistake by not accepting the $15 million five fight deal, $3 million guaranteed per fight deal offer to resign with Top Rank rather than hitting the free agent market. Now, Shakur might have turned down the $15 million US dollar because he's holding out hope that Taki Al-Shiki will give him a fortune to fight on his cards and won't mind if he fights in a boring manner. If that happens, it would be ideal for Shakur because he wouldn't have to worry about entertaining fans and could fight the only way he knows how, with his amateur point scoring style that he's failed to change since turning professional in 2017. Now, we all know that Shakur's style doesn't quite fit the pro ranks. The people pay to enjoy the knockouts. They want a rugged fight. They want a cat-mouse fight. They want a dog-cat fight. They want it all. They want it all. They want it all left on the line. Where fighters are expected to sit down on their punches and be entertaining to sell more of the pay-per-views and sell tickets. Now, Timothy Bradley, a Hall of Famer, feels that that was a good offer from Top Rank and says WBC lightweight champion Shakur Stevenson would have made more than his $3 million for fights against Gervonta Tank Davis and Vasily Lomachenko. Shakur might be under the impression that if he signs with PBC, they will give him the Tank Davis fight, a gold mine with a massive payday, likely far more than the $15 million deal that Top Rank was offering. Now, this also, Shakur Stevenson might get the same offer from PBC or Matchroom Boxing because they know he will likely never be a pay-per-view attraction or a ticket seller by now. According to the fights we have seen Shakur Stevenson being involved in, we all know that boxing fans, mostly the perennial and old days, old generation boxing fans, they love the knockouts. That's why heavyweight boxing was the talk of the town in the yesteryears. So people have the knockouts, people have the exchanges in the ring, the Mexican style kind of fighting. And if Shakur Stevenson gets the fight he's looking for against Gervonta Tank Davis, he will either have to do quite a hiding in there or the 12 rounds if he's to beat a guy like Gervonta Tank Davis. High energy, high knockout power, high ring IQ. So he'll have to change a bit something in his style if he's to impress the fans in there. And maybe if he gets a chance at a unification against Berinchik, put on a good show, maybe stop Berinchik in that fight, then there you got to talk of a wonderful fight with Gervonta Tank Davis. But for now, you don't feel that Gervonta Tank Davis would love to, because if you're going in the ring with a guy like Shakur Stevenson, a guy that mastered the sweet science of boxing, he knows how to hit and not get hit, you in the ring with him and you're risking your career, losing your zero on your record, because Shakur Stevenson can outpoint anyone. Clearly, he can outpoint anyone. Even Gervonta Tank Davis, on a day, he can outpoint him. So you're thinking, if he can't survive the 12 rounds with Gervonta Tank Davis, he will go on to claim that glory. but not in the way that most people would love. He fights most of those big fights, like the way he fought Adrian De Los Santos. He kept on running, hiding, but hitting in a way. He did let his hands go like we used to see, probably because he had that talked of hand injury. But we'll have to do that more against a Gervonta Tank Davis if he's to walk away the winner. But will he get a chance to fight in there? Because even Tank would love the big monies to go in for a risky fight with Shakur Stevenson. And Timothy Bradley coming out to say that he did miss out on a good opportunity when he rejected that $15 million five-fight deal with Top Rank to renew his contract with them. And we all know that so many people, especially on the side where Shakur Stevenson wants to fight, their people are not that much enthused with a fight with Shakur Stevenson. Fad of Gervonta Tank Davis's coach, Kenny Ellis, saying that he doubts that Shakur Stevenson would beat number one rated lightweight contender William Zepeda. William Zepeda is a guy that is promoted by Oscar De La Hoya under the Golden Boy Promotions, and the Golden Boy Promotions are looking at making a fight between William Zepeda and Dennis Berenchik. Dennis Berenchik is promoted by Top Rank, so the Top Rank guys were saying that it might be hard for them to think of going the direction of William Zepeda. It's a high risk, and they're thinking of making a fight between Keshon Davis and Denis Berenchik. So that might be off the list now. But Kenny Ellis, he's trying to be a matchmaker of sorts, pointing Shakur Stevenson towards the side of William Zepeda. I think that is a nice matchup. William Zepeda should give Shakur Stevenson a fight of his life. Shakur Stevenson, after that Atem Haratunyan fight, he was talking of getting fighters who would love to bring their A game to him, try to be in a fight, try to knock out him, and that's how best they can get the best out of Shakur Stevenson, according to him. So what do you think of Timothy Bradley saying that Shakur Stevenson made a mistake of not accepting that $15 million dollar deal with Top Rank? Or was it wise for him to go into free agency? Because now you can easily negotiate your way into fights, like now we see Terence Bud Crawford doing it. But for Terence, we all know that he has had to work his way up there. And with that emphatic win against Errol Spence, you thinking his market value did rise in hefty terms. So what do you think of all this that Timothy Bradley is raising in this incident? Shakur Stevenson is a man that controls his own destiny for now. Place your comment in the comment section below. I sign out. Peace.